judgment. For them to be a judge, they accept his judgment. If he was a bad man, why he came to this judge? Why he came to Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم to judge between them? If I hate you, I came to your room to judge between me and one of the brothers here, Christian brothers. If I know you are a liar, I came to you to your room to judge between me and the Holocaustor or between me and the 2777. Of course I don't come, because I know that you are a liar. I know that you have no. I know that you are ridiculous. I don't care to judge for you, to judge me or to judge the harm between me and anyone of the brothers here. Abraham, I don't care to Christian brothers to judge between me and them. But the Jewish, because we know the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a great man, it's a fair man. Never lie. And it's very fair. And he will treat the case in equality and in full fear and judgment and respect. They came to him, peace be upon him, and they asked him to judge between them on an issue. So he was giving them and exchanging the respect to them, and he told them, I'm going to judge you from your book. I'm going to judge you from your book. And he judged them according to his own book. So no one of them, he will say, no, I don't accept this judgment. It is not my law. It's not my reason. No. Your case is closed. Now come up with the mic and prove again your statement. Where in the Holy Quran say to us that the Bible is truth and correct as you said. Your mic.
No problem. We will close this case because you will keep repeating yourself. But the most important you said, your prophet, he said, holding the book, I believe on you. Holding a physical book which is corrupted. Me myself, I will never hold a book I don't believe in it, saying I believe in you. Like if I ask you right now, if I give you my Bible, are you going to say I believe in you? You will say no. So what you are trying to say to me,
Yes. I'm going to say yes, I believe in your Bible if you ask me to judge between you and one Christian. Now, if one Christian and you came to me and you judge between us, in according to our faith, I'm going to have to read your Bible. I'm going to have to apply to you to the law of your Bible, not to the law of my Quran. It's clear. And I don't care if you don't believe or if you believe in it. You are a sick person. But there is people who I respect. You are not like the prophet. You don't put yourself in the name of prophet. You are not even 1% from him. Not even 0.5% from him. So you don't put yourself like how the prophet, the respectful and the great man, the greatest man on this earth. How he handled this case, Christian brains. You don't put yourself like this, Christian brains. You don't know yourself as a prophet. I'm not repeating myself. I am repeating for you to understand. To stop spreading lie. You know what I am repeating here, Christian brothers? For you to understand that this case do not confirm your funny statement. It's very sufficient, very clear for everyone here. Stop making everyone laughing at you. Any judge in this existence, will have to judge by different law. No, he has to take the book and read this law to judge in according to this law. And the Jewish came to the Prophet Muhammad and they asked him simply to judge between them in according to the Jewish law. And he judged between them in according to the Jewish law. He took this book and he told them, do you believe in this? Okay, I believe in this. Let's judge you through this book. Simple. He judged them during this book. So now, again, close this case because you have got your full answer here. Now, tell us where in the Holy Quran said that the Bible is correct. You, Mike.
Okay, please let me finish, Mr. Muslim Mike. You see, you hold the mic for 10 minutes. You don't let me speak for a few seconds. The important you just said, and everybody heard you, that you are willing to say to me that you believe in my book when you don't believe in it. This is what we call hypocrisy. I will never say I believe in your book because simply I don't believe in your book. Even if you say to me, can you be a judge? Yeah, you see, they want to jump to the question, you know, because they don't want to show that their prophet in here is being unhonest, as Mr. Muslim Knight said. I'm not the one who's calling him that. He said, there's a prophet. He said, I believe in you, but he don't. Now, I will let you give a definition for the one who says something opposite from what he believe in. And you know what I mean. Now, let us go to the Quran and show you. The Quran say clearly that the Bible is true and never be corrupt. Open your Quran with me, Mr. Muslim Knight, please. Chapter 5, verse number 48. It says, he is talking to Muhammad, that we have sent down to you the book with the truth, confirming the books before it and the protector for it. You told me that Allah, he did allow the book to be corrupted, when he is saying he is protecting it and he is confirming it. How he can be confirming a book which is corrupted, and how you can protect it when it is already not exist? So simply the verse in here is saying that Muhammad, he been given a book confirming books before it and is a protector for it. So what this verse saying to us clearly, let us pause the verse. It's not only Muhammad who confirmed that the Torah and the Gospel are not corrupted. By the way, if you go to the verses before, you will see that he's spoken about the Gospel of Jesus and the Torah of Moses. So don't tell me where it says he did not mention the Gospel. So in here, he is converting two things, the Injil and the Torah. And he is even making a promise that he is going to protect those books. Now, how he can protect something you could not protect? If Allah in here is saying that he is giving the Quran and he is ordering Muhammad to protect the Torah and the Gospel, but you just told me that the Gospel is corrupted. So Allah, he could not keep his promise and he did not protect his book, and simply this verse proven that Allah cannot be God. And if we put all things together, we will notice the following. Allah sent down a book. Just wait, guys, let me finish. You will take all the time. You will not leave the mic until you are done, right? Let me finish. Allah sent down the Gospel. Allah decided not to protect it. Why? Nobody have an idea. Allah sent the Torah. He decided not to protect it. And we asked them, is that done by his will? They said, yes, by his will. Which means Shaitan, he did the will of Allah by corrupting the book. Which means Allah, he decided to deceive us, and he is the one who decided to make us believe in a false book, as the Muslims claim. Now, if Allah could not protect his book, who is going to protect the book? Me? You? You just told me that Allah himself is a part of this corruption, because Shaitan, he cannot corrupt his book without his permission, and Shaitan became a partner with your God doing it. In the same time, chapter 5 verse 48 saying it clearly, that Allah saying, in the time of Muhammad, remember this verse came in the time of Muhammad, which means up to that second, the Bible must be very accurate, because how he say we confirming the books before it. How you can confirm books which is not exist, and how you say protecting it when you could not protect it? The mic is yours, Mr. Knight. Thank you.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Please someone put me the verse in Arabic language. That's Wallah al-Ameen hilarious. Put me the verse in Arabic, Ahl Kastar. Who do not read Arabic? Because as well, Christian friends cannot read that, the Quran in Arabic. So please, it's too late. Okay, here is, I'm going to read it for you. I'm going to read it all for you. Hold on, hold on. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وأنزلنا إليك الكتاب بالحق مصدقا لما بين يديه من الكتاب ومهيمنا عليه. الله أكبر. ومهيمنا عليه. ومهيمنا عليه يا كريستيان برنس، if you know Arabic. What does it mean? Your case sentence is in your Arabic. Controlling him. Controlling the corruption on it. Controlling the corruption on it. Brothers and sisters. Brothers and sisters. Christian friends here do not know how to read Arabic. That's sufficient. Lillahi darruka ya Abu Musa. Lillahi darruka ya Abu Musa. You prove to everyone that he really do not understand Arabic in the Holy Quran. Or he cannot read the Quran in Arabic. Now, and what do you say again, by the way? Let us now teach again. I told you, Christian friends, go to Abu Musa and let him teach you the Quran. He offered you already. Why you just turn your back, man, to show yourself by this, by the way? He started now from the